Sylvia. Good morning and welcome to KGO Radio.
A radio station in San Francisco this summer, and these two women are stirring up a hornet's nest.
It was very difficult for Mother to tell me Elvis Presley is your father.
What? This is the daughter of Elvis Presley? There's some resemblance in the cheeks, the mouth, and the hair, but a lot of listeners just aren't buying it.
I think that it's very, very phony, and I don't believe a word of it now.
And that is the problem facing Lucy DeBarbin and her daughter Desirée. How to convince people that Lucy really was Elvis's lover once, and that Desirée really has a right to the last name she goes by, Presley.
I would like to know if the so-called daughter has had a blood test.
Yes, I have. Three.
And they've all come out positive?
Yes, they have.
Lucy and writer Derry Matera, who once worked at the National Enquirer, have written a book, Are You Lonesome Tonight? In it, Lucy explains how she was a tortured teenager when she met Elvis. The year was 1953. Elvis was just 18 and starting his rise to the top. Lucy writes that they fell in love and for the next few years would meet secretly in parks and hotel rooms. One such encounter, she says, resulted in Desirée.
If you've kept it a secret this long and you're not out to make money, how come all of a sudden you've written the book? I don't understand why you just didn't keep it to yourself since you have all this time.
Well, because I never meant to write the book. And it just came about because we were pursued a lot, and Desirée was by the co-writer, Daria Matera.
It's answers like that that will probably keep people wondering whether Lucy is telling the truth. One thing's for sure, Lucy hasn't made any claim against Elvis's estate. But the question remains, why all the secrecy for the past 25 years?
At the beginning, I remember asking Elvis not to say anything about a relationship. He wanted to tell his mother and father, first of all. And I said, please don't. We have to be sure. And that wasn't the real reason. The real reason was that I had a dark side to my life.
Lucy says she was auctioned off in marriage to a man in Mississippi when she was only 11 years old and had the first of three children by him when she was 12. Lucy says this is what she was trying to hide from Elvis after she met him.
That was the reason for the secrecy then. And then, you know, things transpired and I had to tell him eventually. And he still loved me, and that was even the more why I loved him.
A love, Lucy says, resulted in Desirée. A love that no one, till now, ever heard anything about.
Just take a walk down the street to
heartbreak. He's such a monumental figure, I think, is the reason why this controversy is coming about, and because no one wants to believe that Elvis could have had a secret.
But how were Lucy and Elvis able to meet without anyone finding out? How do they avoid all the screaming fans, the snooping photographers, the dominating hand of Elvis's manager, Colonel Tom Parker? Does Lucy have any proof? Something like, say, a photograph of the two of them together?
We are really going to show it in a press conference or some way, a credible medium to show that what we have. I do have a daughter. I will not deny her, and she does know she is his daughter. So that's all I can say.
I'd be more inclined to believe Gary Hart, Spiro Agnew, or Richard Nixon than I would either one of those two women. Thank you.
So that's where it stands for now. Until Lucy and Desirée can come up with proof, they'll probably be hearing a lot more of that. But assume for a moment that Lucy's story is true. She says that Elvis would often phone her through the years. Did he ever find out about his secret daughter? No, says Lucy. But during one phone call in 1977, she says he was beginning to suspect something.
And he had guessed, I think, and he said, in the middle of our conversation, he said, I hope it's true what I think. And I told him soon he would find out how wonderful the secret I had to tell him. And he was very, very happy.
Lucy says she never got a chance to tell Elvis her secret. Within a week, he was dead. So what we're left with is an intriguing story, but no facts to pin it on. Did Elvis really have a daughter he never met? Most Elvis experts and a lot of fans poo-poo that. But Desirée says it really doesn't matter. For her, the king will always be her father.
I honestly never thought I would have to be defending. You know, it's a love story. It's a story to me about two people that loved each other so much. It just happens to be Elvis Presley.